probably live. Hey, good afternoon. Good afternoon. Welcome to Wedding Chat with Mark and Liz from Live Piano. Let's start with a little bit of music and I'll check the live feed. Yeah, well, welcome online. Hello. So I'm Mark, and this is
Liz,
and you may know us as the Live Piano Ltd. So today we should have been at Bartle Hall and doing one of the Little White Books wedding fairs, which we try to do as many as we can, and they're always really good for us. We get a great opportunity to meet loads of fantastic brides and grooms, and we can explain what we do and how we can make your wedding day just that extra bit special. And she's right. I'm looking at my screen. I should be looking at you.
Yeah.
Rookie mistake. So what we wanted to do is talk a little bit through today the way we would have if we were meeting you in person at Bartle Hall. So
a few ideas. A little bit of expertise on how the day might go.
Yeah.
And a little bit of talk about our different styles and how we can add to your wedding day.
Mm. Got to get right on that microphone.
Sorry.
There we go.
I'm feeding back slightly. I don't know.
So what we do is we're available for your wedding ceremony, your drinks reception, and your wedding breakfast. And then we also have a couple of fantastic evening entertainment packages, which we can tell you a little bit about. So
Piano jam.
Yeah. So let's start off with what we do. So if we were playing for your wedding day, we would be arriving at your venue about an hour and a half beforehand. So mainly so that you know that we're there and you don't have to worry. That's the most important thing of a whole day, of course. Less things to worry about. That's what you need. And then we would be setting up ready to play for a wedding ceremony. So when we say a wedding ceremony, we mean we are playing as your guests start to sit down in the wedding ceremony room. Because, of course, at most weddings, you have a situation where the registrars will want to interview the groom, usually in the wedding ceremony room.
Yeah.
So they usually let us in to start playing about 15 minutes before, 20 minutes before, depending on where you are. Some places it's a little bit earlier, like at Sandhall.
Sandhall, where the guests come into the area where the ceremony is beforehand.
Yeah.
So sometimes that might be a little bit early. And what we try to do is just set the scene so that as your guests arrive and come in and sit down in the ceremony area, we're playing some nice music. It's either instrumental piano music from myself or Morgan, or it's piano vocals from Mark. And we just try and make that nice atmosphere as people come into the room to be seated and get them a bit excited about something's going to happen. And it really sort of makes that atmosphere. Should I play an example of something?
Play something you'd play.
I might play at that point.
Yeah, as people are just, in. Guests are just seating at this moment. So try and set the scene in your mind. The guests are just coming in and sitting down. Mixing it up. Just reminded me to do my job as producer. I'm not used to being at this side of it. Okay, so there's a little bit of instrumental music from Liz there that might be as your guests are starting to sit down in the ceremony room. So what we do is leading up to your wedding. Oh, thank you. Somebody just put, wow, this is beautiful.
Oh, thank you
there
very
much.
There
we go. There you go. So.
Doesn't tell us the name.
No. It's anonymous this, so I can't see who you are, but thank you for that.
Oh,
so.
That's lovely.
So when we're leading up to your wedding time, we have a questionnaire that we send out, and that gives us a chance to get to know you a little bit, to get to know what you like, what you don't like. That's also important. Mm-hmm. But we do want you to specify certain parts of the wedding day. And one of the most important wedding parts of the wedding day, of course, is the bride walking down the aisle. And so...
Not just brides, Mark.
Okay, sorry. she reminded me to be inclusive, of course. Sorry. But there's that moment where they're walking down the aisle, and that's one of the most special parts of the day that we need to help make memorable for you. So
lots of people do it in lots of different ways as well. So sorry. Sometimes we have processionals where both partners walk down together. Sometimes one waits at the top.
Yeah.
You know, we work with you to do it however you want to do it, basically.
We can tailor it for you. That's the important thing.
Sometimes people want bridesmaids and page boys first, and then the bride.
Flower girls,
yeah. Sometimes people want two different pieces, one for the bridal party, one for the bride or groom, whoever's walking down as the main person who's walking down. So
it's your day.
Yeah.
It's your day.
Everybody's different.
And you can do what you want with it. And we're here to work with you and make sure that you get what you want.
Yeah.
But
so
just
the
to
usual thing is to have one piece, isn't it?
Yeah.
And we work with you. How many are in your bridal party? How long do you want it to be? And then we can suggest music that fits in with what you want.
Maybe. So also, Liz is an instrumental player. which means, of course, she's playing the piano as a solo instrument without singing. I'm a piano vocalist, so when I play, I sing as well. Different people, we have a pretty even split on people. Yeah. But maybe, Liz, you could give them an example of a piece in your style. That's
Should I do a more traditional one?
Yeah.
Do you want to do the very popular one?
Yeah, well, yeah. You give them a bit of what we get asked for a lot. So this is a very common request. So this is Pachelbel's Canon in D. This is for the more traditional people amongst us. And the good thing is there's a long lead in here which gives a chance to get some bridesmaids, flower girls down the aisle. Now you recognise this hook coming up here. Great lifting moment for the bride to walk down the aisle. Thanks, Maxine.
And the good thing about that piece is you can round it off nicely.
Yeah.
At whatever point you get to the front, we don't just keep going for ages and we don't just stop straight away. We wait until you get to the front, hand the bouquets around, greet each other.
And finish it musically. That's the important thing. We don't just stop. We don't just stop.
And that's the good thing about it being live. We can work with you. If you do get a kid who runs in and gets a bit scared and stops, but then has a minute and then carries on, we can make it longer.
Knowsley Hall has just come on here. Thank you very much. One of our favourite venues and an amazing place to get married. It's every time we arrive at that venue, we're like, wow. I mean, even if it's like raining and dark, it still looks fantastic. And they've just come on and they're saying that we're a must have for a wedding day.
Oh, that's lovely.
Thank you very much. I'll tell you what we should do. We should have a little swapsie.
Yeah.
Because sometimes I would be playing at your ceremony and I'll do a song that I like to do.
Swap over. Producer Liz.
Okay.
So. This is a little bit of a list. There we go. Okay, so can you just give me a bit of that? Hello. This is a very popular one. The popular one, I think.
So popular.
Heart beats fast. Colors and promises. How to be brave? How can I love when I'm afraid to fall? Watching you stand alone, all of my doubts suddenly goes away somehow. One step closer. To walk in. I have died every day waiting for you. Darling, don't be afraid. I have loved you for 1,000 years. I love you for 1,000 more. All along I believed I would find you. Time has brought your heart to me. I love you for 1,000 years. I love you for 1,000 more. And if you're there now, we can round it off nicely as you get to the top of the aisle.
Such a gorgeous song, isn't it? It's just lovely.
You know what? Turn that stuff off there, that reverb for the singing. You know what? What song? That's probably the most popular song.
Yeah.
But one of my favorites to play would be the Coda Line one. I love that one. Tell me that you want me. and I'll be yours completely, for better and for worse. First did this one at Knowsley Hall. I know, that we did this one for the Percival wedding. It was a beautiful wedding at Knowsley Hall. And the chorus is great because it lifts like this. You make my heart feel like it's summer. That's how I know you are the one. Great words for the wedding.
Yeah.
Shall we swap C again?
Yeah.
Woo! We should have two pianos. Mm. We've got four.
Yeah.
So, there's some ideas for the wedding ceremony entrance. So,
Can I do one more quickly? because it is another very popular one.
Yeah, I think you should.
Which is, I think sometimes people have always thought that they would walk down the aisle to Here Comes the Bride,
yeah,
which you would traditionally hear in church. Sometimes I do still play for church weddings as well. If people are getting married in church, but they don't really want to have the kind of organ vibe. But
well, Liz has been playing the church organ since she was like
12.
12. So
don't say how many years it is. It'll give my age away.
10 years.
So I can come into church with a piano and make it have that more modern feel for you, but still beautiful music if that's what you'd like.
And our pianos sound great in a church acoustics as well. Yeah,
they do, yeah. So some people have always thought they would walk down the aisle to... It's a bit Marmite. I think people are a bit like...
Yeah, some people really want it, some people really don't. So.
We do have a lovely modern version of that song, which I play quite regularly these days.
Yeah, so it's actually by Jonathan Cain, who people that I know would know is the keyboard player from Journey, but he wrote this for a film. I don't remember what film it was. But this is the Bridal March in a modern style. That's a beautiful piece. That's for the more traditional couple who want, who want to tip their hat to tradition,
yeah,
but not necessarily have the pomp and ceremony of the original bridal march. That's
quite
a good
often
one.
Play that one and then play more modern songs afterwards. Mm. So
we've walked you down the aisle, with musically speaking. Mm. So the next thing that we ask you to choose. Now this is really up to you. I mean,
yeah. How much input that you would like, really.
You don't have to choose all the music in your wedding. Yeah, you can. The highlights would be, we needed to choose the wedding ceremony and walking in and walking out, basically. Mm-hmm. And also, perhaps, if we're playing for your wedding breakfast, you know, the
entrance,
walking in from that as
yeah.
well. So those are the highlights. But some people like to prescribe more of the music and be more control.
It's nice to choose songs that are special to you both as well. So if mm. you've got any special songs, we can play those while you're signing the register, which is a really mm. nice thing to have.
Yeah, so for the signing of the register, we usually suggest if you want to leave it to us and let us do our thing, then, you know, we have the experience to really make that special for you. But if you want to choose some songs, we usually ask you to choose two or three songs, which is for your signing the register. And of course, the registrars won't let anybody take photographs while you're signing the register. They'll then give you a dummy register where your guests can then take pictures, because it's a sensitive document. Mm-hmm. Could you pass me that? I've left a mess. Sorry. Mm-hmm. So maybe Liz, you could play us something you'd play in the hugging the piano today. Oh, this is a nice one that she's got coming up. There was a bit of Ed Sheeran there. Get a lot of requests for this one. So there's an idea of what Liz might play if she was playing for your signing. That last song there is Heaven, originally Bryan Adams, but people know the DJ Sammy version.
It's quite nice if you want to go for that sort of modern dance music sort of vibe, you know.
Yeah.
Things like symphony I play as well, which I'll do a little bit later on.
So normally I do stuff there like Amazed by Lone Star, mm-hmm. or maybe All of Me by John Legend. Mm-hmm. And these are very popular songs. So,
exit.
We get to the exit. Shall I do an exit song first? So this is, we're going to have a little swapsie over here. It's almost like a system, this. You can almost see. So normally we come to the exit music. And what's important about this, we think, I mean, obviously it's your choice, but what we think really works well on this is something uplifting. Because if you imagine... They will announce you as a married couple. They turn you to face your congregation, and they say, ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for the new couple. And then you leave, and they all follow you out, hopefully having some fun. So what I play usually is this one. Ladies and gentlemen, your bride and groom.
Ooh, yeah. Like a fool, I wait and stay too long. Now I'm wondering where my heart belongs.
Should be pretty much about enough to get you out of there. That should be about enough for you and your guests to
It's very noisy to live
boogie
with
on out there. Liz, do you want to play something that you play for? Requested a lot for it. We're going to do a swap sheet again. Okay. I'll go this way. You go that way. There might be some humour yet when one of us falls off one of these stools, I think.
Yours is really wobbly.
A really wobbly stool they've got today. So that's this is what Liz often gets requested to play. Haha, I did that. Sky Full of Stars there by Coldplay. And that's a very popular one amongst our brides anyway. And if there's anybody watching out there, by the way, who's had any of these songs, then please give us a thumbs up. And we've got a few people watching at the moment. How are you doing? Yeah. Give us a few comments.
Quite a few on the live piano page, I noticed, watching. That's good. Hi.
So that's the end of the ceremony. And
so should we talk a bit about moves?
Moving.
Baby.
Moving. So, we use exclusively our white Dutch grand baby grand pianos. Mm-hmm. The reason we use the white ones is because we think when you've dressed your venue beautifully, and we come to these venues and they look stunning, you know, some of the fantastic people have red floral and
flower design,
the flower design and creative
Rose
cover.
Boutique. And Alison at Mottram Hall.
These people have booked these fantastic suppliers to make these rooms and these venues look absolutely stunning. So we don't want to turn up with a keyboard and sit there and play.
Okay,
so we have these, so we have these white piano shells by a company in Holland, friends of ours called Dutch Grand, and they look fantastic. Now, they look like a real piano, but the great thing is they can be moved. So
you
when
can
you
buy.
Even Liz gets it. People see Liz carry. I wish I put a picture on that I could show. People see Liz carrying this thing, they can't believe it. But what we do is when we finish your ceremony, we fold it up and we move it, if you want us to the drinks reception area.
Which could be, if it's summer, it could be outside, as long as it's dry. We do ceremonies outside as well. It might be into a bar area. Every venue is different, but we can move. once we've obviously we can't sort of follow your guests around, but we do once we sort of move once per part of the day, so we're quite happy to move and set up and place somewhere else for your drinks reception.
Yeah, so we've also bring, you may be able to see in the back of this shot here, we have these Bose speakers and they sound fantastic and they're quite easy to move as well, and they fill a room. I've used the speakers like this, like in the gardens at Eaves Hall.
Yeah, large marquees at Thornton Manor.
The terraces at Knowsley Hall, outside Knowsley Hall. So if you want to take your drinks reception outside in summer, we say as long as it's dry to touch and we can reach it with power, and we do bring long extension cables with us, mm-hmm. then we can do
even
it outside.
It's just through a window.
Yeah,
so you
yeah.
Lift the window and throw it through.
So for a drinks reception, so what we do for drink reception is on the questionnaire that I mentioned earlier. By the way, if you just joined us, you're on Wedding Talk with Liz and Mark from Live Piano Limited. How you doing? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Check out that switcher action there. So
still need a bit of practice on the production side of things.
You're a better producer than I am.
I've had more practice.
But I'm a better singer. So
so true.
So if we play a drinks reception, we tend to play pretty much from our own selection. However, with the questionnaire that we talked about earlier on, we try to get an idea of what it is you like. And also, we often get the guests coming up to us asking for requests as well. A little bit of Ed for you here. Yeah, so are we going to swap again?
Yeah.
This is already, excuse me. Ooh. So if I'm playing for your drinks reception, what I tend to do is I want to keep people's feet tapping because, you know, that's my best playing, that is. The people are, it's a long day. It's a long day for everybody. So we want to keep them engaged. We want to keep them interested. So I tend to play some foot tapping stuff. So here's an example. I never thought I'd miss you half as much as I do. I never thought I'd feel this way, the way I feel about you. As soon as I wake up, every night, every day, I know that it's you I need to take the blues away. It must be love, love, love. It must be love, love, love. Nothing more, nothing less. Love is the best. So there's that. I like playing that one. I do a few other things like. Sunshine on a cloudy day. Get them feet tapping. When it's cold outside, I got the month of May. Yeah, I guess you'd say, what can make me feel this way? Oh, my girl. Talking about my girl. Ooh. And of course, with my, 18 years of piano bar experience, I can field some requests. And we tend to get the groomsmen, particularly the guys coming, hey, mate, play me some Oasis. So we do. Gonna be the day and they're gonna throw it back to you. Right now you should have somehow realized what you got to do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. So there's a few examples there of what I would do in a drinks reception. Keep people's feet tapping. And even we can even get some full on party vibes going if we need to. We're taking requests. Oh. Yes, musical chairs. It's true. We should have done like a Julian piano setup, but we are in our own house, so
we could have set
multiple pianos up, but we're a bit short on space here. I've got to have my drum kit set up. It's very important. Yeah. Trapped in the house with all these people for weeks. I've got to.
When he plays drums all day, it's great.
Mm-hmm. So that was it. Drinks reception.
Drinks reception, and then we move.
So then we pack up and we move again, and it takes us. When we are talking about your wedding with you, we will most likely know the venue reasonably well because we've played many, many, many venues in the Northwest. If we don't, we do our research, get in touch with the venue. And of course, we have a public liability and PAT testing that we need to perform anywhere that we that you want us to, within reason. Liz has made us climb to the top of Rivington Pike with the pianos one time. That was fun.
And a drum kit.
Mm-hmm. So when we're talking about the moves, we do need to check that the moves are reasonable.
Yeah.
So, you know, we can move a reasonable distance. They're not overly heavy.
For
we have trolleys.
For example, a Bartle Hall will move from the manor house into the wedding barn. That's fine.
Yeah, so we can
even
move
though it's
there.
A different building, you know, it's a short walk.
Yeah.
We don't really want to be walking, you know, a 15-minute walk across a complex.
Yeah, sometimes you have large wedding complexes where everything's at opposite ends and you pretty much need to drive between them. So we sort of draw the line there a little bit. But we can advise you on that, and we can advise you on how to get the most value out of us for your wedding day as well.
So if we just mention now the different packages we do and the unforgettable wedding package. I did want to talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, I was just going to finish the thought, though, with the wedding breakfast.
Okay, should we talk about that first?
Yeah, because I was thinking, when we do a wedding breakfast, the important thing is, and this is a question a lot of brides and grooms ask, will you be too loud?
Yeah.
Will people be able to dine while you're playing? And that's, again, going back to our nice Bose speaker over here. The thing about our sound is that it spreads. It's not like deafening the person right here.
Next to it, yeah.
And you can't hear it at the other end. It doesn't work like that. It spreads. It fills the room because of the high-tech, very expensive speakers that we use.
Also, we do work with the crowd because I always say this to people, every wedding is different.
Mm.
You can do three in a row of a weekend.
At the same venue.
They are all totally, totally different depending on the guests and you and what you want at your wedding. So for a wedding breakfast, I have extremes where I might have where everybody's very well behaved, everybody sits, chats nicely on the table, enjoys the music. I hear people play name that tune and, it adds a talking point for people, but it doesn't take over too much. It's just there in the background. And that's what a lot of people want for their wedding breakfast.
And sometimes.
Sometimes
people, the table wine starts to take over.
Yeah. And we can sense how it's going and we go with you. So if it's feeling like people just want it in the background, we tend to stay more in the background. I do, certainly.
Yeah, there's a definite ambient noise metric, isn't there?
Yeah,
so you can tell from the what's going on in the room how people are feeling, and we try to just amplify that a little bit.
Yeah.
So, Liz, if you're playing nice and gentle for a crowd who perhaps are sitting and they're just... a lot of decorum in the room. Also get a lot of brides, particularly, who really want a lot of Disney in their wedding.
Yeah.
Liz has a lot of Disney in her repertoire.
Yeah.
yeah, that's in no way representative of the grooms. Yes.
So yeah, that's a lovely one, and we can go along that. I play quite a lot of film music.
Yeah. So let's show Maxime a little bit more musical chairs, ready? Ding 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 ding
ding ding ding ding. Taking my orange with me this time.
Okay, I've got the microphone now. So if I was playing for what are we on? Wedding breakfast, that's it. If I had playing, wedding breakfast.
Had a few people go, why are you staying overnight and playing for our breakfast?
Wedding breakfast is not sausage and eggs and hash browns.
Someone said to me, so do I have to provide you with a room?
Yeah, if we play for our breakfast. The wedding breakfast is the first meal that the couple have as a married couple. So, I suppose it can be bacon and sausage. We've seen stranger things. Yeah. But, you know.
I like it when they have a cheesecake with cheese.
Cheesecake. Yeah. Cheese. Cake. Yeah, I probably shouldn't play to that stereotype, should I? So, if I was playing your wedding breakfast, which, you know, is usually about 4 in the afternoon. I would start off nice and gentle like this.
Yes.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money. Boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live and stay in.
Yeah, stay in. Someone's put, Mark, every one of my guests at my wedding breakfast best be up, stood up dancing.
Well, yes. So I was just getting there. So some people, I start quite gently, I think, because it's important. People come in the room. If they know each other, they want to catch up. If they don't know each other, they want to get to know each other. Mm-hmm. We need people to be able to sit and talk across the table, and we're not interfering with that moment. That's very important. However, this is where we get a bit of fun. Around dessert time, I like to change it up a gear because, I always say, well, it's time for the fun food. So let's have the fun music.
And it often kind of builds throughout, doesn't it, the wedding breakfast. You know, people pick up on songs they like, they start asking for requests, they start singing along, and it tends to have that kind of a shape where it builds.
And again, it's not a forced thing. We follow the crowd. And by dessert time, you can feel it. You can feel it's ready to go off in the room. So there'd be things like...
It's Lauren and Tom at Formby.
Is it Lauren? She's checked. We have.
I bet they're still up from last night.
Yeah. They were partied with us last night in our live feed. Yep, lockdown live we do on every Saturday at 7:30. Oh, the cat's come to join in. So I might do where it began. I can't begin to know it. That I know is going strong. So this is a good one because we get the hands, napkins in the air, touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you. So there's an idea. I also have had people dancing around the tables. Yeah, at coming out of my cage, and I've been doing just fine. Got it down because I want it all. Started out with the kids, how did it end up like this? It was was only a kiss. It was only a kiss. So we get that going on, and we've had people dancing around the rooms. In fact, if you check out our YouTube page, which is youtube.com/livepiano, you'll see on there, there's one wedding, Eve's Hall, Mr. and Mrs. Shaw.
Yeah.
That was a fantastic wedding. Outdoor ceremony in the gardens, blazing heat. It was a glorious day. And then in the wedding ceremony, they just went crazy. Mm. And it was great. It was great fun.
Drink, wedding breakfast.
Wedding breakfast. What did I say?
You said wedding ceremony.
Oh, no, they didn't go ceremony. No. In the wedding breakfast, and we had them all dancing around the rooms. Napkins up in the air. We had that recently as well. Where was it when we did one together?
West Tower,
yeah. Yeah. So.
And with my style, I tend to play. People who tend to book me all day tend to want the instrumental piano music. Mm. However, I have had weddings where, same thing, we watch it build, and I have certain songs that I play that I know get people singing along, and I've had people stood on chairs.
Have you got one for
well.
Me?
Yeah.
Musical chairs. Bum, 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 bum.
So, again. Obviously, you haven't got the singing from a person leading the singing. However, people, when they've had a few, do enjoy.
We have, and I've just got to say, I am on my screen here. Yeah. I can only see Facebook user, yeah. So I don't know. It I don't know who you are. But somebody's asking, can we play the songs a bit longer? I think what we'll do is we're just trying
too
to get.
Talking.
Yeah, it's me and me. I'm trying to get through the content for people who are. Interested in what's going on with weddings, because after all it is wedding talk. But we will play a couple of songs in the entirety before we finish. Any requests as to what they are?
Requests, please.
So, the fun you can have when you're a musical family.
What I was going to talk about how, so that people can obviously see the differences between my style and your style.
The microphone, please.
We do have our favourite package. Can I say that? Sounds a bit weird. Our favourite package of all is called the Unforgettable Wedding Package.
So this is where, I'm going to rewind you slightly, actually.
Okay.
Sorry. Because when you book, ordinarily, you book one or the other of us. So
Morgan.
Or Morgan, yes. So you have instrumental piano from Liz or Morgan, or piano vocals from me. And we find that there is a divide in people want one or the other, usually.
Yeah.
There are a couple of exceptions for that. If your wedding song, if you really, really want to walk down the aisle to an if you want me to sing for the day, but you really want an instrumental song for your walking down the aisle, then I'm happy to do one or two. It's just not really my style. That's the only thing. So.
But you're never going to get singing from me, afraid. Or dogs will howl.
But what we do, for those people who really want sort of Liz's ambient style along with my entertainment style, we have what we call the Unforgettable Package, which is basically, it's kind of a buy one, get one half price situation.
Yeah.
So normally we go out to work separately, but if we do the Unforgettable Package, we come together, we we bring two pianos. And what that means is we can always be set up ready at the next place.
Yeah.
And we play more for you on that day.
Yeah.
So we do maybe pre...
Yeah, there's two you can choose from.
Yeah, yeah. So like if we're playing somewhere like, say, Knowsley, where they've got a really nice welcoming area for the guests before the ceremony.
And lots of rooms for each section of the day.
Yeah, yeah. What we would do is we'd put one piano perhaps in the entrance hall.
Yeah.
Where one of us will be playing.
One in the ceremony room, the ballroom, where they get married. Then while that person's playing, whichever one of us you want for the ceremony, the other person is moving, ready for the drinks reception, which might be in the same area the first one was, but or it might be outside. And then while that person's playing, the other one of us is moving, ready for the wedding breakfast.
Yeah. And
so that we're always in the right place at the right time.
But some venues, after the wedding breakfast, will move you on to a bar... while they prepare,
turn around time.
We call it turnaround time, where they're preparing the room, the DJ or the band is setting up for the evening, which we'll get onto very shortly. And that is when we might set up somewhere in a bar, and I would usually it's me that does that because I would then be playing some entertaining music, a bit of rock and roll, a bit of pop music.
So the two choices you have are pre-ceremony, ceremony, drinks reception and wedding breakfast,
mm-hmm.
or ceremony, drinks reception, wedding breakfast and turnaround time. So we cover four parts of the wedding day instead of three.
But if you book one of us,
yeah.
we only do up to three parts. And our pricing structure is such that we want you to be able to choose what you want, and you're not paying us on the clock, because I don't really think it works with weddings to be on the hour. It's like, weddings run over. The things run late. Bride's prerogative to be late.
Yeah.
You know, things run over. We can't be going, oh, we're done now. See ya.
Yeah.
And take off.
Take a piano.
It doesn't work like that. So what we do is we say, we are paying us for the parts of the day we're playing.
Yeah.
And we have price packages to show every combination. So we have a price package for ceremony only. Ceremony and drinks. Ceremony and wedding breakfast. Drinks and wedding breakfast, ceremony, every permutation. And the thing is, if we're not playing, we're not charging you. That's the way it is. I'm here, aren't I? Mm-hmm. So it doesn't work like that.
So if you would like to find out more about our packages, they are displayed on our website, livepiano.co.uk. livepiano.co.uk. Or you can send us a message and we'll send you an email with all the prices and the packages all together with video links to show you how each package works.
Now, I just wanted to quickly touch on something that I brushed over there, which is evening entertainment. We also have evening packages. I'm going to just flash this up on the screen there. My evening show is called Piano Jam. You can book me to come and entertain for the evening, which is live piano music with a drummer. We also have a dueling piano show, which is called Piano Jam XL, which is very popular. You go on our YouTube, youtube.com/livepiano, you'll be able to see some fantastic weddings that we've done, some great videos on there.
And quite often people book me in the daytime and an evening piano show in the evening, then it means that the whole day is covered with live music.
That's the perfect solution. Liz playing all day and me playing all night, and that's we've done that a lot.
Yeah.
And the thing is about the evening show, it's a full request show with a full request DJ included, which is also me. So basically I'm on your stage for the whole night and I can present the parts of your wedding day, like the cutting of the cake and sing your first dance live, which is a really nice special touch. Which somebody just come on and said, we've booked you, Liz. Fingers crossed everything still goes ahead in November. We're still toying with which songs to choose. Well, there's no hurry.
So, yes. Also, to help you decide, so we do have a questionnaire system. We send you a link to our repertoire, which will give you ideas. We have YouTube playlists you can look at to see the sorts of things we play. And we also offer FaceTime or Skype or video call with you from our house so that we can play for you rather than just meeting you and talking about
it. Well, that's what I was going to say. A lot of people ask us, so can we meet you before the wedding? So... it's difficult because we'd have to have a piano, really, in order to discuss properly what we do.
We like to choose what you like.
So the way we do that is we either invite you along to one of the many wedding fairs that we do.
Like open evenings.
We should have been with Little White Books today at Bartle Hall, one of our favourite venues where we're recommended suppliers there.
We do monthly, generally open days at Mottram Hall,
Knowsley
Hall,
Lancashire
Ashfield
Manor.
House, and Lancashire Manor, Weathermist.
Oh, so many. We should have written it down, really, because we don't want to omit anybody. But we're very also very grateful, of course, for all these wedding venues inviting us in. They always treat us so well.
Did I say Knowsley?
Yeah. So what we do is we also let you... we also have meetings with you, but over the internet, which, of course, the technology is advancing now that we're all stuck at home. So if there's ever got any... What I always say to brides and grooms is, please call us before you start stressing, because there's no real need to stress. We can solve it together, and we can do it over Skype, and we can play some ideas for you, and you can choose it, and that's probably the best way to work it. So I've got a request here for us to, shut up.
Stop talking.
And play more. And somebody's requested this piece by...
We were trying to do a podcast style thing, weren't we? A bit more.
Heaton House Farm. Yeah, sorry.
Heaton House Farm.
Of course.
You see, we love Heaton House Farm as well. It's brilliant.
Yeah, you know, the thing is I'm going to have to put a blanket apology out there because we should have scripted this a little
Could
better.
Did I say Farmby Hall as well?
Farmby Hall, with Jenny.
They're fantastic as well.
Yeah, we've probably forgotten more than we've remembered, so we apologise. But we're thinking on our feet, well, bottoms. So we've had a request for Liz to play this lovely piece by, I'm going to call it, say, Yuruma. River Flows in You. How I feel. So as for booking, it's quite simple, really. We have somebody says that was beautiful. So we have a quite simple booking system, really, where we do like an online system. It's secure, paying by card through Stripe. You message us, we talk to you about what your package is that you want. Rewrite the Stars. Got a request for you, Liz. Do you still play Yours by Ella Henderson? House, yeah,
beautiful song,
fantastic venue as well, multiple award winning venue. We're actually very lucky with all our venues because they're all fantastic, and so we're a bit spoiled, really. She's got a microphone in her face. Thank you. said that. It gave him goosebumps there.
Well,
that's what we want to do. You see, that's the main goal for the wedding days is to we want to ramp up the emotion. You know, make you really remember the day, enhance the perfect day. That's our goal. And when we do, you know, it's a fulfilling part of our job, isn't it?
Yeah. Let's do a song.
Yeah, and then we're gonna sign off very shortly. Mm-hmm. First of all, I've got a couple of little announcements as well. We first of all like to thank all the guys at Little White Books for hosting this online wedding fair.
Thank you.
We're all stuck in, so I'd like to thank you all for being stuck in. You know, you're staying in, you're saving lives. Thank you very much. And as such, we're really grateful to Little White Books for allowing us to bring the wedding fair to you. From our house directly to yours. So that's one thing. Tonight, for those people who were wondering about my entertainment style for the evenings, I'll be doing a little microcosm of what I do, which I'll be appearing in Mulligan's virtual bar this evening. If you look that up, Mulligan's.
Does that mean I get to drink more beer?
Probably, yes. If you look Mulligan's virtual bar up on Facebook, you'll find that there's loads of different artists, many from the wedding industry, many fantastic ones, friends of ours.
We've got
are
the
on
Rush,
there.
Gavin Jones is on at 6, I think. He's
Andy Murphy's playing tonight, fantastic wedding DJ. There's going to be...
I think you got the worst slot because you're competing with Her Majesty.
Yeah. So if you're not watching the Queen's speech at 8 o'clock...
Is she still doing it?
I don't know. If you're not watching the Queen's speech...
Or when she's finished, they can drop in to Mulligan's bar.
I want you there at 8 o'clock.
Okay. Sorry.
Mulligan's virtual bar. I'll be doing a live set tonight with a bit more rock and roll than all this.
Yeah.
Piano jam light. Me.
I'll be
solo.
Producing like Roz in.
Speaking of producer Liz, do you want to get back in your producer chair for a moment?
Okay.
Yeah. Oh. Hello again. Musical chairs one more time. I'm going to do one. What should I do?
I don't know. So, a love song.
Yeah, yeah. So. Testing. This one's a popular one for weddings. When I look into your eyes, it's like watching the night sky or a beautiful sunrise. There's so much to hold, and just like them old stars, you find that we've come too far. Right where you are, how old is your soul? 'Cause I won't give up on us, even if the sky gets rough. I've given you all my love, I'm still looking up. 'Cause when you're needing your space to do some navigating, I'll be here patiently waiting to see what you'll find. 'Cause even the stars, they burn, some even fall to the earth. We got a lot to learn, God knows we're worth it. 'Cause I won't give up, 'cause I don't wanna be the one that walks away so easily. I'm here to stay to make the difference I can make. A difference is due a lot to teach us how to use the tools and gift we got. Yeah, we got a lot at stake. We didn't break, we didn't burn. He has to learn how to bend without the world caving in. I gotta know what I
in who I am. Cause I won't give up on us, even if the sky can't roll. We got a lot to learn, and God knows we're worth it. Cause I won't give up on us, even if the skies get rough. I've given you all my love. I'm still looking up, I'm still looking on.
That's lovely. It was Charlotte Brindley who was asking for Ella Henderson.
Yeah, we have no
I'm just looking on here.
She's no names written. Yeah. That was a little appearance from Ben there. We're going to get off this feed in a second, and we're going to go and spend some time with Ben and his trains, I think.
Yeah. So, do you want me to finish with one?
Yeah, yeah.
It's, Tom has been very supportive.
Feed
we've done, he's been there commenting. That's one you're working on.
I'm working on it. It's in the
James Morrison song.
I love James Morrison because he that song particularly, that what he did. You wanna leave me here in the morning. You wanna hold me when I sleep. Cause I was meant to tread the water, but now I've gotten in too deep. I like this song. Cause every piece of me that wants you, yeah, another piece backs away. Cause you give me something that makes me scared, alright. This could be nothing, but I'm willing to give it a try. Please give me something. Someday I might know my heart. Yeah, I really like him. I will learn that song for you, Tom, I promise. It's coming. Musical chairs. Yes, Tom. Tom says, keep up the good work. Oh. Thank you very much. And this is part of why we're doing this as well, because we want people to see, you know, that we're still going strong. And all those people who've been contacting us, rearranging weddings, thank you for working with us so well. It's a difficult situation for us, and the absolutely best thing we can do is move your wedding to a time when we can still be there and still do what it is you wanted us to do. That's the best thing we can do for you at the moment. So if anybody's got any worries about dates and stuff like that, get in touch by email. That's the best way, because we have so many. That's the best way we can...
Penciled in weddings left, right and centre,
yeah,
aren't we?
Yeah, that's the best way that we can...
We're doing our best for everybody.
Yeah,
So I was going to finish with one that is a modern song, which is really what we specialise in, isn't it? You know, playing modern songs that everybody knows, rather than sort of, you know, what people might expect when they see a wedding pianist. They think, oh no, this is going to be boring and it's going to be very traditional, which is not really what we do.
They always leave with a different impression, though, don't they? That's the important thing. They always say, who are those guys? So that's the way we want it. So we're going to finish up with this song. Liz Hendry, wedding pianist. Mark, the piano guy. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching us. Thank you to all the folks at Little White Books for hosting this today. Don't forget to check out our website, livepiano.co.uk.
And the Facebook page.
Facebook page, Live Piano Limited. And YouTube as well, youtube.com/livepiano. We really hope all those brides and grooms have supported us in the past 6 years that we've been running. Thank you to all of you. Thank you to all the brides and grooms that have booked us in the future for having faith in us to enhance your wedding day, which we certainly will do everything we can. And also, all the future brides and grooms, we look forward to getting
forward
to know you.
Getting back to it, doing the weddings and the wedding fairs, which is what we love to do.
Yeah, in the meantime, guys, I know it's tough, but stay home, stay safe, look after yourselves, look after your loved ones. And
if you would like us to play something maybe for you next time we do one of these, send us a message on the Facebook page or by email, and we'll see what we can do.
Yes, thank you very much. Have a great weekend, everybody. See you at 8 o'clock, Mulligan's Virtual Bar. Party time. Oh, yeah.